Listen.
People remember they treated us very unfairly. They didn't give us due process. They didn't give us a lawyer. They didn't give us anything. Now they come to the Senate and they want everything.
Joining me right now, Democratic Congressman John Yarmuth from Kentucky. Thank you for coming in, Congressman.
Sure. Good morning, Kate.
Good morning. So the president saying once again that the House process was unfair, but now saying why it almost implying why then should Democrats expect a fair process in the Senate? What do you say to that?
Well, first of all, he's totally lying about the process. He was invited to have lawyers present. He was invited to call witnesses. He chose not to. He didn't participate in the proceedings at all, calling them a hoax and unjustified. That's his privilege to call it whatever he wants. But to say that it wasn't fair because he decided not to make it fair is ridiculous. And I think the argument is the same with whatever happens in the Senate. There will be, at some point, a need for votes in the Senate to decide whether to call witnesses or not. And I would hope that they are able to get 51 votes to do that. I think Mitch McConnell's in a real bind here, regardless of what President Trump says. I think Mitch is going to face severe criticism, and as the polling has showed, not just from Democrats, if he makes short shrift of this whole proceeding. And yet, if he calls witnesses, allows witnesses, then I think the president's case is going to be severely damaged. So I think he's really made the calculation right now, at least, that he's safer to have basically a non-trial trial than to call witnesses, which would undermine the president's arguments.